Let us now study the female reproductive system. All the organs of the female reproductive system are in the abdominal cavity. In male reproductive system, we had seen that the testes are present outside the abdominal cavity. But in case of female reproductive system, all the parts, all the organs are in the abdominal cavity. Now they comprise of a pair of ovaries, a pair of oviducts, single uterus and vagina. So these are the important parts of the female reproductive system. Pair of ovaries, they are the reproductive glands that are present one on the either side, and their main function is the production of female gametes, that is ovum or oocytes or the egg cell. So apart from this, hormones are also secreted by the ovaries, that is progesterone and estrogen. Then we have oviducts. You can see two ducts here. These oviducts are initially, you can say, finger-like structure here or funnel-like structure, and then they get continued in the form of ducts. And they have their openings into this huge bag-like structure, which is the uterus. So oviducts are funnel-like or finger-like projections they have, and they hold the ovaries. And they get continued, and they have their opening into the uterus, which is a large muscular bag-like structure. So the uterus is very muscular and it accommodates the growing child. Finally, we have the vagina, the last portion. Now, vagina is a muscular canal that is lined with mucus and nerves. We can say that the vagina is the connection between the uterus, cervix and the outside of the body. So it is the vagina which is going to connect the uterus and the cervix. Here we have the cervix, the mouth of the uterus, that is called as the cervix. And it is through the vagina that the uterus and the cervix are connected to the outside. So these in short are the various parts of the female reproductive system. Besides, a pair of Bartholin's gland is also present. Now Bartholin's glands are present in females. They are the size of pea, and they are present one on either side of the vagina. So right and left side of the vagina, we have pea-sized Bartholin's glands, and their function is to secrete mucus and keep the vagina lubricated. So this is what is the function of the Bartholin's glands. Now generally every month an ovum is released in the abdominal cavity alternately from each ovary. Free end of the oviduct is funnel like. An opening is present at the center of it. Oocyte enters the oviduct through that opening. So from the ovary, one ovum, oocyte or female gamete is released. When is it going to be released? Only when puberty is reached. Puberty is the age when the oocytes get matured and they are ready to be released. Now every girl child is born with about 2 to 4 millions of oocytes in the ovaries, but they are immature. Only at the age of puberty, which is about 10 to 17 years in girls, these oocytes get matured, and one ovum or oocyte from either of these two ovaries is released. There is a small opening in the oviduct through which this ovum enters into the oviduct. Now the eggs are immotile. The female gamete, oocyte, ovum, they are immotile. They are not capable of moving. But there are small cilia or hair-like structures, we can say, that are present inside the oviducts. And these cilia keep the egg moving, and finally it reaches the uterus. So there is an opening that is present at the center of it, that is the center of the oviduct. The oocyte enters the oviduct through that opening. From here it enters into the oviduct. Cilia are present on the inner surface of the oviduct. These cilia push the oocyte towards uterus. So through the cilia or the hair-like structure, the egg is made to move forward and finally it reaches the uterus. So this is what is the path that is taken up by the egg, and these are the various parts of the female reproductive system. Let us now talk about some important terms. Firstly, gamete formation, sperms in males and oocytes in females. We have already done this when we were studying the reproductive systems. Sperms or the male gametes, we saw that they are produced in the testes and through the seminiferous tubules, which have got germinal epithelial cells which undergo meiosis, and they give rise to sperms. So the sperms are produced in the testes, and they are produced from the time of maturation. Now, this maturation is referred to as puberty, and the sperm production in males continues till the death. So the age for puberty in boys is about 12 to 16 years. During this time, the sexual maturation and fertility is achieved. So this is another important term, that is puberty, that is period of sexual maturation and fertility. Secondly, oocytes. We have seen that every girl is already born with 2 to 4 millions of oocytes in the ovaries, and but they are immature. They get matured only after the age of puberty is achieved, which is about 10 to 17 years in girls. And after that, one ovum or oocyte is released from either of the two ovaries. So that is what is gamete formation, and both these gametes are formed due to meiosis. Puberty also we have seen. Coming to menopause, the stoppage of the functioning of the female reproductive system is called as the menopause. This age in women is about 45 to 50 years. And during this time, secretion of hormones controlling female reproductive system either stops or becomes irregular. So this is what is referred to as menopause, that is stoppage of the functioning of the female reproductive system. So from the age of puberty up till menopause, the age of puberty, as we said, from 10 to 17 years, and the age of menopause, which is about 45 to 50 years. An ovum will be released every month from the ovary, that is out of about 2 to 4 millions of ovum. Approximately only 400 oocytes are released up to the age of menopause. So remaining oocytes are going to undergo degeneration. They undergo degeneration. So that is menopause. Coming to fertilization, fusion of male and female gamete resulting in the formation of a diploid zygote is known as fertilization. We have studied this definition earlier in sexual reproduction of plants. Same is in case of human beings also. Fusion of male and female gamete, that is sperm and the egg cell, resulting in the formation of diploid zygote, is known as fertilization. So we know that the egg is immotile, and through the cilia present in the oviducts, it is pushed and brought into the uterus. Now the sperm cells are motile. The sperm comprises of head, which contains the genetic material, and the tail, and which helps the sperm in moving. It even has got mitochondria because it will require energy to move. So the sperm cell is capable of moving, whereas the egg cell is immotile and it is going to be brought into the uterus with the help of the cilia. The fertilization in case of human beings is internal, and the semen is ejaculated in the vagina during copulation. So this is internal fertilization. and the semen is ejaculated into the vagina, and during copulation the sperm cells, due to presence of the tail, can move up to the uterus, and if it can fuse with the egg cell, out of millions of sperms, only one is capable of fusing with the egg cell to form a diploid zygote. So these are some important terminologies with respect to the human reproductive system.